Hey everyone, we're here live today, and we're actually at Danny and Marilyn Graves' property. That's my daughter's husband's parents. And give me a thumb up if you can see me out there. I'm not sure that I've got a signal, but I think I do. So anyway, we're broadcasting here today, and we're calling this Breaking Ground. Oh, I see somebody coming up. And the reason I'm coming on in a hurry is because there's a concrete truck on its way, and I'm trying to get this in. So that backhoe behind me is breaking ground, and we are in the process. They're getting ready to pour a slab here, or pour footings rather, and then they're going to build their house here. Let me read this scripture to you. It's Hosea 10 and 12. I said, plant the good seeds of righteousness, and you will harvest a crop of love. Plow up the hard ground of your hearts, for now is the time to seek the Lord, that he may come and shower righteousness upon you. So he's telling us to plow up that hard ground. You know, I worked for a farmer years ago, and this was the first time I ever had really run tractors. And at one point I was disking, and that was fine because that ground had already been broken up. But he had ground that had never been broken up, and I had to use a chisel plow to break that ground up. And when I use that plow, man, that plow just takes and it turns that ground over, and it's ground that has gotten hard, and now it's got to be where it's pliable so you can work with it. That's breaking ground's an exciting thing, because when you break ground, they're breaking ground for a new home. They moved from Louisiana, just took a step of faith. But when you let God break the ground of your heart, when you get broken before him and you plant the right seeds, it changes everything in your life. The old hard heart, the old way of life that you knew, that was all you knew, passes in a moment. The Bible says that old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. So when you look at this behind me, this is a work in progress. And if you look right at me, this is a work in progress. You see, we're constantly letting God build on this house. We're asking him to mold us and shape us and make us and turn us into that vessel of honor that's fit for his use. They've been working hard here. What you didn't see was this was full of trees. They've come in here. They've cut down trees. They've bush hogged. And now they're getting ready to pour the concrete. They came in with a backhoe. They've dug the footing. They're going to pour the footing today, and then they'll be getting ready to pour the foundation, the slab, the foundation. We need that foundation, and we've got one, and that foundation is Jesus Christ. I'm encouraging you today that no matter where you've been, no matter what you've been going through, no matter how you felt in the past, your heart may have become hard over disappointments or things that broke your spirit, that you promises that were made, that people made to you, and they were never kept, and it turned you hard or cold or maybe even indifferent. But today is a day to break ground. Today is a day to say, hey, God's going to build this house, and he's not going to finish until he's completed the work in me. So I want to encourage you that no matter what you've been going through, no matter what you're facing, go ahead and say, God, here I am. I'm asking you, God, just to come into my heart. Break this ground, Father, and plant the field, God. Give me the harvest that you intended. You want me to reap joy, not sorrow. You want me to experience your presence, God, because in your presence is fullness of joy. So I'm just asking you today, Father, to reach out and touch people. Lord, break that ground up that's been hardened. Father, let them see a new day. Spring has sprung. And it's time for us to look around us. There are trees that are beginning to bud, flowers that are beginning to bloom. And my friend, I think that's a spiritual place that God is saying for us that now's the time, that it's spring, winter's over, it's time for new life. So go ahead, pray this prayer with me right now. Would you, Father, I just ask you in the name of Jesus to break this heart of mine. Lord, I humble myself before you and ask you to have your way in my life. God, speak peace to my soul. It's time, Father, for all those things that you promised, God, those things that I've read about in Scripture, God, that I know are true. Lord, I lay hold of them right now, and I ask you, God, to plant a new harvest in my life, and I thank you for it now in Jesus' name. Hey, it's exciting around here today. There's a lot of activity. People are moving around. They're trying to get everything ready because that cold, dark winter is over and new life is in the air. Let that new life enter your heart. Let it touch your soul. And remember, if God is for you, who, my friend, could be against you? You need to get ready and expect a wonderful harvest because the seed of His Word is being planted today in Jesus' name. Love you guys. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.